excuse me.
Hey, why is he talking?
Oh my god, no! Don't burn me
everybody, it's your boy the Slap Train, and welcome back, guys. Midnight Club LA back for episode number 10, man. We are on double digits today, and I gotta say, man, I am pumped to be back in this game. Now, we had an absolutely awesome weekend. I'm gonna explain that in a little bit, but today, though, guys, we gotta get rid of some wheels, man. Look at how much space we have left in our garage. We have half of it left, which means that we gotta free up some of these slots, man, because honestly, I'm not going to drive half of these cars. They're sitting here collecting dust. Now, one of them is going to be this Group B muscle car Camaro Dub Edition. Now, we ended up getting this last episode for our tournament win. Now, a lot of people may say, Slap, keep the Camaro, man. What are you doing? But to be honest with you, we already have a muscle car. Mind you, it's not a Group B muscle car. It's still a muscle car. So, I mean, at this point, we don't have any challenges that require a Group B vehicle. So, I think I'm going to let this thing go. That's kind of my plans, just because of the fact that we're going to get $36,000 from that, which in turn, I can go ahead and buy myself something. So, I went ahead and got into it, which was not what I wanted to do, man. Like, just look at this thing, man. It looks like... it just looks ugly. I don't know what you want me to call this thing. It looks absolutely hideous, and that is why we are going to sell it. I don't know, man. Did I make a good decision? Let me know in the comment section down below, ladies and gentlemen. But also keep in mind, though, we just got $36,000 for doing so. All right, 36 grand. Now, the second one to go is definitely going to be this damn RX-8. Not really a fan of that, and we do have a tuner for our Datsun 280Z, and we also have our damn S14. So it's kind of, you know what I'm saying? It's kind of that, do I want to do it kind of thing? I don't know. S14, 240, whatever, man. I don't give a shit. I don't know. It's a toss-up. Alright, I think I've made up my mind with this. We're going to go ahead and sell the RX-8 as well, too. Personally, I don't need it, man. There's no need for that. C-Class, another tuner. That's going to be a third tuner. No problems. Get the hell out of my damn garage, man. We're going to go ahead and equip our Ducati 999R. Sounds like we're German in this video. 999, I'm just kidding, man. Alright, so either way, though, like I said, this weekend, I ended up going to Medieval Times. It's my girlfriend's birthday on Tuesday, so it was a nice kind of outing for her. Went with a couple of her family. We went with a couple of good friends as well, too, man. Had an absolute blast there. We ended up getting first row for the Red Knight. First row for the Red Knight. I was absolutely ecstatic getting first row. And I think we're going to do a little bit of first person for today. Oh, my God. This is going to be interesting. First person on a bike. Man, this is going to be absolutely crazy. I don't think I've done this for a long time on a bike. We're just going to dismiss that. Don't worry about it. So we're going to go head over to the hills to make some extra coin. Looks like right over here. Excuse me, man. Get the hell out the way. But I told you guys that I was actually at Medieval Times way back in the day. Now, I'm talking, oh my God, I wasn't looking. I'm talking like grade 4. I was at Medieval Times. It was a classroom trip. I don't know if any of you guys went there for your classroom trip in grade 4, but I ended up going there, and it was an absolute blast. I loved it. I still remember it to this day, and I went there, you know, expecting it to be a little bit different from when I went there as a kid, and I gotta say, it was identical. Everything was identical to the actual, you know, the dinner, the tournament, everything was what I remembered, and it was pretty damn crazy. I'm not gonna lie, we picked up some souvenirs, because back then, you know, you couldn't drink. Oh, Jesus, my bad. You couldn't drink when you're there, because I mean, shit, I'm like 9 years old, man. You can't be drinking alcohol. So we ended up getting a really nice souvenir mug. We ended up getting a whole shit ton of beers. I ended up picking up myself a little miniature samurai sword on a stand, which can actually come right out of the holder. really damn cool. I'm going to overlay some photos for you guys just to have a look at what I'm talking about. But I had a blast, man. Girlfriend had a blast. Everybody had an absolute blast. It was a lot of fun. A lot of people were saying that, you know, it's usually rigged where the one knight wins all the time. Now, in this case, I went there. We were the red knight. The blue knight ended up winning. The blue knight. All right, so I had people saying that the white and black knight won, you know, stuff like that. But blue knight won when I went. So I don't know if you guys went and there was a different knight that went. But if you guys did go to Medieval Times, I want to know which knight won when you guys went for that night. And we have a challenge and a half. We have a Lamborghini going up against us. And I don't know if this first person is a good idea or not. I'm a little bit nervous. I'm not going to lie to you. Get rid of this damn song. Like, look at this. How the hell do you even see with this? This is crazy, man. Thankfully, we got zone, and I can use that. We're going to hit some spray. Hitting a buck 80 almost. Ooh, excuse me. Man, why is he talking? Oh, my God. No. Go, go, go. I seen that coming, too. That's the problem with being in this view, man. It's so trippy on your eyes that you cannot comprehend what is going on. And I think we lost this game as soon as we had a Lamborghini going up against us. I mean, like, come on now. That's cheap. Ducati versus a Lambo? This ain't 1320 video right now. Like, come on, man. All right, we're gonna try to pull something out of our ass on this one. I don't know if it's going to be possible or not. Let's get a wheelie or some shit going here. Maybe we'll get a little bit better. Yeah, there we go. Look how soft that wheelie looks. Hell yeah. Woo! But this weekend, though, like I said, we ended up going out to Pickering is where I ended up going around. Now, we actually have the Pan Am Games being hosted in my hometown. Now, if you guys don't know what Pan Am Games are, just Google them, man. Just Google them. But on the highways out here, they actually, son of a shit, and we got ran over by a taxi cab. Oh my god, it's just looking absolutely horrible. And the frustration begins with the bikes. Doesn't help we're going up against a Lamborghini that's just already miles ahead of us. Like, where is he? No. Now, as I was saying though, man, on the highways where I... Did I just really Did I re-wager another $6,700? I hope not, man. I ain't got that kind of money. All right, come on now. So the highways where I live, they have a what's called an HOV lane. And that's a lane where it's kind of... That guy, he threw it in my way, man. Oh, my God. This is... Jesus, get out of the way. Oh my god, we just lost about $17,000 in a matter of a couple seconds, just like that. Oh my goodness, I can already see the comments right now. Slap, I told you not to buy the bike. Man, you better not be putting any of those comments in this bitch, because I do not need to hear them right now, man. We need to win this race is what it is. And look at how fast he's going. He's gone, man. That's not even fair. Another race, another loss, you know what I'm saying? Thankfully, that was breakable. That would have sucked. Really? Really? Really, physics? Okay. This is just... These are one of those times right now. You know you have those times where you want to just break your controller? You know what I'm saying? You know what? Yeah, this is one of those times right now, man. That's how frustrating this is. Oh my god. Especially because of the fact that I just lost another damn batch of cash, which we just sold that RX-8. That RX-8 that we sold earlier, we just got maybe $4,000 from it. Look at this guy. He's already doubling back right now. Like, that is just ridiculous. Might as well just quit the damn race. We're just going to quit it. Might as well. There you go, quit it. Perfect. Oh my god. Shut your ass up in your expensive Lamborghini. We're gonna beat Carol. Do we have a B-class vehicle is another question. I know we just sold a B-class vehicle, which was our damn Camaro. this whole episode has just took a... It pretty much just took a nosedive is what it did. And I haven't even got to finish my story. The HOV lanes, two lane vehicles or two passenger vehicles can get in there. And essentially what it was because of the Pan Am Games, it was only now you had to have three people in your car to be in this lane on the highway. And no word of a lie, cops were sitting on the side of the road just looking down the highway. Police bikes just looking down the highway waiting for someone to come down that damn road in that lane with two or less people. You know what I'm saying? They were just scoping, man. It was absolutely frustrating. I only had two people in my car, so I couldn't go in these lanes. So I was stuck in just bumper to bumper traffic with all the idiots. Oh my god. We had to class A. Don't even have a group B. Okay, guys. This is one of those times where I need your moral support, because I'm about to break down, man. I'm just kidding. Maybe, though. Maybe. Who knows? I may just take out this game and smash it. I really don't know, man. Midnight Club LA will bring out the worst of anybody. Ask any real player. I don't even know what to do right now. I don't even know what to do, man. Don't have a luxury vehicle. Don't have a B-class vehicle. I ain't doing highway races. I don't want to do the damage targets. Jeez, now let's go to the comments, man. One good thing about today. This damn bike is definitely not one good thing, I'll tell you that. Junior Jabra says, and we're going to try not to crash our bike as we answer these because the controls are just so twitchy. Alright, he says, Slap, please, if you can, I beg you to bring back Burnout Paradise. Oh my god, I'm looking, man. I'm looking over here. I missed the gameplays of that back in the day, man. Burnout Paradise probably won't be coming back just because it's not really as fun as it was back in the day when it was really popping online and you had everybody playing. Now it's just kind of, you know, whatever kind of game. I would say if I was going to go back to any Burnout, I don't give a shit about the cops, man. Take care. If I was going to go back to any Burnout, it would have to be Burnout Takedown or Burnout 3. God, on a Monday. What do you expect, man? It's a Monday. Can you really blame what's happening? Oh my god. Might as well hit some more comments while we're running these cops. Don't get killed, please. Somebody said, here we go. I just want to die, man. I don't want to die. Police pursuit. He should be, he can't even see where the hell I am. How is he still in pursuit? Explain this, please. My guy just goes limp. Alright. The J-Man63 says, love the drawing. You know what? Screw the cops, man. Screw it. I'm just gonna sit here, right here. No, I'm just sitting here right now. I ain't even gonna move for you guys. Screw it. He goes, love the drawings you show in the vids. Ever think of showing a slideshow to give credit to the amazing artist that drew the cars? Now, in every one of my postings that I do post, I always include the name of the artist. It's always found on the top right hand of your screen. It'll say the Facebook name. Those are the people that actually post the drawings, all right? So it's not just a random... Okay. I'm close, man. I'm about on that verge, you know what I'm saying? To just say, screw it! But we're gonna... try to hold it together this episode. Look at this. We even went on the wrong side of the road. Nothing's working for me today, man. Nothing. Should I just... Okay. I'm about 30 seconds away from selling this bike. You know what I'm saying? But I ain't gonna do it. For the sake of the bike, we're gonna just keep it. Now, SeanKiller90 says, hey, dude, I don't think you'll read this out loud in the vid, and that's okay. But I wanted to say as a long... ass time watcher, I am cheering you on. Hope you are still what? I hope I am still an active watcher when you hit the big 1 mil subs. Been with you since the OG channel and just wanted to let you know your determination to grow will succeed. So am I doing on behalf of all other loyal watchers and myself, great work and always take care. SeanKiller, I know who you are, my dude. I see you always in the comments. Big ups, big thank you for sticking around, making an appearance back again in the comments section down below. I've seen your comments for a long time, my man. Do not think that it has not gone unnoticed, because I seize it, you know what I'm saying? I seize it. But big thanks, my dude. Big thanks for watching. channel hopefully is going to keep on growing, and we're going to keep on sliding, man. Now, right now, we are almost out. How come it didn't give me the option to fix my bike? Huh? This game is not liking me, and just because we have a bike now, we're getting matched up against, you know, the best of the best. And they are just absolutely mopping the road with this. Like, this is crazy, man. Oh, boy. Cars are flying. We have to really not hit anything. If we hit one thing, that's it. We're done. Screw these bikes, man. That's just too dangerous. One of the reasons why I don't drive on the road as it is. All right, come on, man. We got this. We have got this. We have to, man. We gotta make... Jesus! Okay. I'm not good, man. Look at me. I'm on the road. Wow, we just lost another $3,800, man. Now, Lolcats Plays commented last episode. Y'all remember when he rage quit on this exact race? Sir, that comment is not the best place to be read right now. You know what I'm saying? I didn't need to read that comment right now because I'm pretty damn close myself to rage quit. God, man. Oh, my jeez. All right, stay back there, my dude. No. Look at how fast that damn 4GT is. He is so fast, I can't even get the speed boost. Oh, my God, my dude. I need some help, and I need it right now, man. This is tough. We ain't gonna even go on oncoming. I ain't about that life, man. Thankfully, we have one zone accumulated. We hit that slowdown if necessary. But look at this, man. It's not even possible. I feel like Brian O'Connor right now in the last race of Fast and the Furious. Trying to catch up to that Dodge Charger. Just no damn luck. Had to spray. Here we go. Yes. This is where we come back. Here we go. Woo! Oh, Jesus. No. Go. And look at him. He's gone. Bye. Take care, my dude. It was nice racing with you. Oh, my God. Now, ladies and gentlemen, what you guys can expect from the channel this week? Drive Club Dirt Rally is going to be making an appearance early. We're going to have a mobile Monday hitting us up at 4 o'clock for today. I also would like to get back into a consistent posting date with our Slap Gaming channel. We've been posting some other things other than Batman, but I also want to get back into Batman this week. So I'm going to be playing that a little bit more, maybe posting some CSGO or even live streaming it, not really too sure yet, but definitely want to get back into Slap Gaming. Got a brand new intro over there that was done by Underground Auto. If you guys would like to go and check him out in the description box down below. He's also posted my intro on his channel, so if you guys don't know what the channel intro looks like yet, go and check it out. I know there was a lot of people saying, Slap, you need a new intro for the second channel, man. I seen it almost on every video. I seen it, man. Just a matter of getting it done, but it's done, and I could not have been happier, man. It came out absolutely awesome. I love it, and I hope you guys do enjoy it as well, too. No! If I don't win this race, if I don't win... No. No! Son of a jit! Oh, my God. God, ladies and gentlemen, how does... Goose Fraba, you know what I'm saying? Goose freaking Fraba right now, man. Ladies and gentlemen, you know what? We're cutting it, man. I'm cutting it. I'm going out to get some fresh air because that is what is needed. We cannot win. We can't win right now. We cannot win on this Monday. On this glorious Monday outside, we can't win. I don't know, man. Ladies and gentlemen, big thanks for stopping by today. Big thanks for watching me lose a shit ton of cash. How much money do we have right now? How much? Hold on. Get my damn controller from the ground here. Okay. We got zone level 2. Whoa, big whoop. I don't really care right now because we just lost a shit ton of cash. We didn't win a single race on this episode. Outclassed, eh? Okay. I can't help that my bike likes to make 180s in the middle of the damn road, man. We have $62,000, ladies and gentlemen. $62,000. How much money did I... Oh, my God. So just so everybody knows, okay? Just so everybody knows, when we started this episode, we had $82,000. 82 grand we had. And now look at us. 62. We lost 20 grand, man. Oh my God. Ladies and gentlemen, if you guys enjoyed this episode today, don't forget to slap that like button. Show me the support in the comment section down below. And if you have not already, you guys can follow me on Facebook, Instagram. Just my luck. No, go ahead and hit me too. Appreciate it. Instagram and Twitter, all of which can be found in the description box down below. Midnight Club LA, episode 10. Losing 20 grand right now. Oh my God. It's your boy, the Slap Train. I'm out. Peace. Everybody, it's your boy, the Slap Train, and welcome back, guys.